So, work due to forces applied at an angle. How do you keep a balance on your head, though?
Magic.
Yeah.
If you had the angle, just putting it into the equation, would that be the equivalent of finding the x component and putting it into the equation?
You're always like three steps ahead, Cece. I like your passion. I love your passion. All right. So here's this mass sitting on this surface. And let's apply this angle. Actually, you know what? Let's apply this angle upwards at an angle. So, you know, like pulling on a toboggan or something like that. And we can give ourselves a little angle between the horizontal and the applied force. I'd like to make it 40 degrees. And I'd like my applied force magnitude to be 15.0 newtons. Now, I'm going to make this a frictionless surface. Just because we've dealt with friction quite a bit in the previous unit, and I want to focus on the energy just now, okay? So we've got a frictionless surface, and we know from the past that work is equal to force times displacement times cosine of theta. Oh, let's give ourselves a displacement here. Again, let's make it nice round numbers. Let's say that our displacement is to the right 10 meters. And again, I'm using my displacement vector in red just to emphasize the fact that it's not a force and therefore not attached to the free body diagram. Okay. So work is equal to force times displacement times cosine of theta. And we say that the applied force is equal to 15.0 newtons. The displacement is equal to 10.0 meters. This time, cosine of theta. We got cosine of 40 degrees. And 15 times 10 is 150. No problems there. Times cosine of theta, and the units are going to be newton meters or joules. But what's cosine of 40 times 150? Hannah?
114.91
joules. Oh, my notation's getting sloppy because I'm getting nervous under this video camera. But okay, and we can round it off to 3 sig figs. And 115 joules is going to be our rounded value. Now, Cece says, what if we sort of rethought why we were doing this cosine theta? What if we said, really, the reason this cosine theta is here is because we want to find out what the x component is of that original applied force? Well, that's absolutely right. That's what you're doing. You're really mapping the component of the applied force onto the displacement that we're achieving. Okay, so we're trying to find the component of this applied force that points in the same direction as the displacement. And that's all that cosine theta is doing for us. Okay, in fact, if you want to do that, if you really wanted to think, reconceptualize the way you think about it and say, look, I know the applied force off at 40 degrees. I want to recalculate the F applied X and recognize that work is F applied X times delta D times cosine of theta. And if I'm finding F applied X and my displacement's in the X direction, then cosine of theta comes down to being 1 because theta would be 0 then. It might simplify your calculations. It might not. You get the same answer either way, though. It depends on how you think about it, I suppose. But you're right. Using these raw numbers and plugging in a cosine of theta of 40 degrees or finding F applied X and then doing your calculation, equivalent results. Okay.